Hi everybody, this is Nick Tenbrook and we're here with jazz pianist Michael Wolff to talk about the ins and outs of John Coltrane's tune Giant Steps. Let's talk about just the basics of the tune first and just go through it slowly and show everybody the changes.
Right, here's the song. Chords are B major 7, D 7, G major 7, B flat 7, E flat major 7. It's a pattern, then it does it again a major third below. If we go turn around in G, we go A minor 7 to D 7. Now the same thing, it just repeats a major third down. G major 7, B flat 7, E flat major 7, F sharp 7, B major 7, turn around to E flat, F minor 7, B flat, E flat major 7, A minor 7, D 7, G major 7, C sharp minor 7, F sharp 7, B major 7, F minor 7, B flat 7, E flat 7. Now turn around and get it to B. So what you're basically doing is you're going, taking a B chord, B major 7, then you're doing 5 of the major third below, which is D 7 to G. Now 5 of the major 7th below, which is E flat. B flat to A, B flat, right? Now you do the same thing. G, major 7, B flat, E flat, G flat, or F sharp, B.
Great. So, as I've always pointed out, this is actually a beautiful tune. It's not just an intellectual exercise, and that's what makes it a classic. So let's just talk about a few approaches to playing through the changes. The first of which is basically just, playing the chords, arpeggiating the chords.
Right, that's a good idea. So we have, if we're going to do, you could do just the triads like B, D, G. But I think it's a little more interesting to actually do the major 7. So we have B major 7 to D 7, G major 7 to B flat 7. So I could do a very straight arpeggiation. I'll do that, you know. A little boring. So let's just say I take those notes from the chords, which the B major 7 is obviously B, D sharp, F sharp, and A sharp. And the D is 7 is D, F sharp, A, and C. I'm going to take those and I'm going to play just using those tones, but I'm going to try to make up ideas. What I'm going to do on this is I'm going to take the 7th chords, the notes. And then I'm going to try to make something out of them. You know, so that's basically just using the arpeggios. Now let me just try it with just the triads. It's kind of fun.
Okay, that's great. So now we've dealt with the basic chords. Now let's talk just with the most basic scale-wise, almost diatonic approach.
Okay, well you could just take the scale for each chord. You know, B major 7, you're going to just play the B major scale. D7, you're going to do D mixolydian, which is basically the G major scale. The G major, you'll do G major. B flat, you'll do B flat mixolydian, which are the same notes as the E flat scale. And the two fives will just do we have an A minor 7 to D 7 to G. I would just do all of that as G major, or you can think of it as A Dorian, D mixolydian, G major. But I like to try to make it as simple as possible, so I would just do the whole thing thinking about G. So let's try that. Thank you.
shows you is that without getting too carried away thinking of modes, if you think of them as key areas, with three basic key areas, you can play the entire tune, which is B, G, and E flat. With those major scales, depending where you play them from, you can get through the whole tune just with those three, and that makes it easier to get a hold of in your head. Okay, now the next thing is, let's talk about sort of the pentatonic approach.
Okay, the pentatonic approach would be B pentatonic to D pentatonic. Pentatonic means five-note scale. Generally, you go the 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6 of major. You could do it minor, but we're going to just do these as major. D, so that was B, right? D, G, B-flat, E-flat, G-flat. So I'm going to just do that again. I could play them very kind of stiffly, like...
pentatonic, you don't always start on the root. Like oftentimes with these kind of chords, you'll actually start on the fifth and play your pentatonic, right?
Sure. I mean, there are five notes, so really, and you don't have to even do all of the pentatonic scale. It's just to give an outline. Just all these things are just intellectual, sort of harmonic, melodic ideas to get you going. When you're playing music, you want to play music with this thing. So when I'm playing, I don't just say, oh no, I'm going to do pentatonics, but I do have all these as the tools that I'm going to use to try to hear it.
Right, I think that's really important.
Yeah.
Okay, so now let's talk about what we just call the big five approach, which is if we're heading towards E-flat, we're going to play some kind of B-flat altered scale for over the first several chords.
Right, so let's just, we start, we go B, D7, G major 7, B-flat 7, E-flat. So to me, this whole, that whole thing is just to get from the B, right, to the E-flat, and then we're going to go to the G. So what I was thinking to do, just give myself something interesting to do, is either play a, we could play the altered scale, you know, B-flat 7. Now the B-flat 7 altered scale, which would be a big 5 of E-flat. It's augmented, a sharp 9, flat 9, and sharp 11. So while this is going by, scale. And then it resolves to the E flat. I'll do that again, slower. It sounds better fast, though. And then I'll do the same thing here. So I'm going G, B flat, E flat, F sharp to B. I'm going to B, so I'll play the 5 of B, which is F sharp altered. F sharp. C, D, E. So we have the root, flat 9, sharp 9, major 3rd, sharp 11, flat 6, flat 7. So I would do that here. The same thing, right? I'll do that faster. So this, I'm going to do this altered scale. Still going G, B flat, E flat, F sharp to B, but I'm just taking the 5 of B, right? Here we go, so I'm gonna do the 5 of B.
Right, and just structurally, the reason that approach works in this case is that both of these sequences start with a major 7th chord, so the major 7th of the B can be called a B-flat or an A-sharp, so that's how you can even use a B-flat type of scale. And the same thing happens
right.
In the next key, when it's a G major scale, you use an F-sharp.
I mean, the scale that I really prefer is the double diminished scale. which isn't as correct in a way musically, which would be, it's almost like that alto scale, but it's an even, it's half step, whole step. So it would be, you have the still the flat 9, the sharp 9, the sharp 11, but you have a natural 5. So you have this for B flat, B flat, B, C sharp, D, E, F, G, A flat, B flat. It's a sound you hear in jazz. It functions well for 5. So then I would do the same thing. If I'm going to this, I'd start with B major 7, going to the E flat from B, I'd play that scale. And then I'd do the same thing here. I'm going to go to the 5 of B, I'm going to play the F sharp. So I'm going to F sharp this. So I found that really effective.
Right, that's good. And the way we're trying to show you approaches that make this a little easier than it seems at first. It can be daunting. Okay, now let's talk about moving down by whole steps instead of following the third approach.
Right. Well, you could just, it's actually a really cool bass line. Instead of going B, D, G, B flat, E flat, the bass can just go down whole steps because when you go from B to, you go to A, which is the 5 of the D. So I'll play the chords in the right hand in a different bass line. The bass player can still play his regular stuff. And I can just think of my right hand moving down. I could take pentatonics and move it down. Or I could just play triads down, you know.
I think what all these things show is when you're really, as Mike was saying, when you're really playing a solo, you, in a way, once you're familiar with all these approaches, then you mix them all up, and that's how you actually...
Yeah, you're trying to teach yourself what to hear. What you can do is just play the major scales. You'll either be playing B, G, or E flat. So first I'll start with B, but I go right to the G. Now the E flat scale, G, E flat, B. Try to find one scale that goes with a couple chords. G, B, go to E flat, B. But I'm not going to play them in like that. That sounds like an exercise, so I want to play it like. Is a mix and match. So let's say I want to do, I'm going to arpeggiate a little bit, you know, pentatonics. You know, where I'm going, I'm mixing and matching. Now I'm going to do one where I'm going to do the scales, the pentatonics, down whole steps. You could do all of it. Pentatonic. Step. So I mean that's the thing in improvising. I'm just trying, then you can just play.
I think what this really shows is that to improvise on any song, you have to know it inside out. And one of the great ways to really get yourself to grasp a tune and really be hearing it is then to try it in a new key. So let's just do that slowly. Let's just pick a key one.
Yeah, okay. Let's try, you tell me, pick a key.
Pick a key.
Well, I'm not saying I'm going to do it well.
I don't care. Let's just, since we're in the world of thirds, let's do it, you know, starting on G.
Okay, so let's see. Right. I don't know if that was right, but we'll see.
We'll find out.
So let's just say I was playing on.
Take 6 months or a year or more to assimilate all of it, but these are just techniques to use to get you through what's a difficult situation. Now, one thing we really didn't talk about, which I think is particularly germane in this song, is chromaticism.
Right.
Let's just talk about that.
All right, well, with chromaticism, obviously there are 12 chromatic tones. You can start on any note and go up. Right? That's it. That's a chromatic scale. So, I mean, and, you know, you can try to make play chromatically and have the downbeats be the chord tones, I guess.
Coverage of Harmonic Approaches to Giant Steps. Hope you enjoyed it. Look forward to seeing you next time.